drummer. Music hit your heart, cause I know you got a soul.
Hey,
listen if you're missing, y'all. Swinging while I'm singing.
Hey,
giving what you're getting. Knowing what I'm knowing. While the black band's sweating. In the rhythm I'm rolling. Rolling. Gotta give us what we want. Gotta give us what we need.
Hey.
Our freedom of speech is freedom of death. We got to fight the powers that be.
Freedom of speech is freedom of death. We got to fight the power that be. What's up, people? March 22nd, Tuesday. This is the In the News portion of the No PC show. Going to have a good show for you on Thursday. It's called The Angry Black Man. The elephant in the room. Should be very interesting. We'll try to put our spin on it, our black spin, even though I hear some people, oh, it's just too black. Everybody doesn't want to hear about black. Has the problem going away? No, they should be hearing about black. We're going to kick it right off today. Ain't got a lot of time. This is going to be a short segment as usual. We're starting off today. Most of this is Chicago news. The uncle that gave the young lady who shot and killed Adina Martin 2 years ago receives 100 years. He deserves an ass whooping on top of that 100 years, even though he's in a wheelchair. You know, the ignorance sometimes goes beyond belief. You're a grown ass man giving a teenager a gun so she can go out and do something stupid. She's still awaiting trial. I thought this was the most ignorant stuff I would hear, but today earlier there was a man in Houston, Davis Wilson. This bastard has had sex with a 2-year-old baby, infected the baby with HIV, herpes, and other sexually transmitted disease, as well as having sex with a minor, a 14-year-old, who also has contracted AIDS and herpes and other. And I'm thinking to myself, what is wrong with these people? Have we gone that far in the world that, you know, it just makes no sense no more? They both deserve a foot in their ass, and I hope they get it, and we don't feel sorry for niggas that behave in this manner. Moving right along, we're going to talk about this. This is just a different type of ass. This is a rich man's problem. Everybody knows about the Adam LaRoche saga in Chicago, that he was going to walk away from $13 million. Contract because he wants his son to be at every practice and all this other nonsense, and it became a whole big fiasco that has gone on for over a week, and finally Jerry Reinsdorf has stepped up and supported his staff, as it should be. Just personally from being in the locker rooms and stuff myself, it's no place for your little 14-year-old boy. And why isn't he in school? And if you're homeschooling him, why isn't he there? He has no place to be around grown men, even though your father did that for you. Too bad. Bring him on. Bring your child to work day. People just fucking amaze me. You obviously got enough money if you feel like you can walk away with $13 million. I get damn how good you are. Walk. Peace. See you. Don't forget your son. On a more serious note, the Chicago Fraternal Order of Police, I don't know if you saw this earlier, have, I believe they have successfully pushed through, or they're waiting on a vote. I think the vote is already taking place, though, where they will be allowed to destroy police misconduct records older than 5 years. How does this benefit the public? How in the world do you destroy records? Oh, so you don't have to see headlines like this. Chicago racks up $662 million in police misconduct bill. So it's just deployed by the city. Rahm Emanuel and his floozies. To save the city lots of money. Because if you can't find these records, then there's no case. So then you can't sue the city. See how that works? See the ignorance that we constantly deal on. These guys, a lot of these guys, may be getting ready to collect their pensions, getting ready to walk away, getting ready to retire. Last thing they want is a misconduct thing that's going to put that in jeopardy. It's corrupt. Chicago's just a corrupt place. Let's finally admit it. It's corrupt and it's ridiculous. And I don't know who voted or who, what judge is allowing this, because whoever is allowing it, they need to be investigated too. Period. It makes no sense. Your record's not going to be expunged. It's going to ride with you forever. So theirs needs to ride too. And why hasn't, in all this time, this been moved over to some media, electronic media? But guess what? When you do evil dirt, somebody gets way ahead. So before they've had a chance to delete these records or get rid of them, there's a Citizen Police Data Project site out there. It's cpdb.co, or type in Citizens Police Data Project. And guess what it does? It lists all the complaints that have been alleged against Chicago police officers. Now, this is just Chicago. It's probably crazy all over every place else. The amazing part is, out of 56,384 allegations, only 2,295 were sustained. What I like about this site is they list every officer. So it's 8,923 officers out there. You can go through this site, and they're probably going to try to shut it down. So, you know, get it while you can. All the officers' names, nationalities, how many complaints, how many disciplinaries. And the great thing is, you can click on that person's name and it will take you to another page. I'm just here trying to give you the information. You know, we don't spoon feed around here. We just give you information that you can use, and you can go out there and have some type of political insight yourself. Look at this guy. And it also lists officers that were involved in cases with this officer. So right now, this is all the information they're trying to destroy. This is what they want to destroy. Amazing, right? Nobody's standing up. Nobody's saying nothing. Nobody sees the pink elephant in the room. See, you can stroll down. You can see all the stuff they did. Illegal searches. Use of force. Drug, alcohol abuse. This is his record. This is your protect and serve. So this is information they want to get rid of. It's already going to cost the city $662 million, right? We need to find a way to stop this. That's what the city is saying, because they're losing a ton of money. That's why they ain't never got no money. And they're always reaching in our pockets. But I just wanted to share that with you all. Hopefully, it's been some information that you can use. But we're going to do it like we always do on the show. Love, peace, soul. We catch you on Thursday.
As the rhythm's designed to bounce with transcendental rhymes, designed to fill your mind. Now that you realize the prize arrives, we got the pump to start to make it hot. From the heart, it's a start, a work of art to revolutionize, make a change, something strange. People, people, we are the
the same. No, we're not the same, because we don't know the game. What we need is awareness. We can't get caught.